back to our YouTube channel. If you don't remember, my name is Mory and I'm one of the recreation therapy interns. So for our video today, we're going to be learning how to fold and organize our clothes. And there are multiple ways that you can organize your clothes. You can categorize them in different sections, like their shirt sections, jacket sections, pants, socks, intimates. You can organize your clothes in the closet with hangers or in drawers, color code them. Any way that you like. And there's a lot of different folding techniques as well too to help you fold and organize your clothes, which is the purpose of this video. But for today's video, we're going to be organizing our clothes with by using drawers, and then we're going to be separating our clothes into four different categories, which are going to be shirts, jackets, pants, and socks. And then the folding technique that I'm going to be introducing you all today is called the Marie Kondo technique. And Marie Kondo is a Japanese decluttering consultant, as well as a TV host and author. And I learned her technique this past year, so I'm a little rusty on it, beginner level rusty, but I'm hoping to share that folding technique with you all so that you can better fold and organize your clothes. We're gonna first start by sorting out our clothes and separating them into the four sections that I discuss. So we're going to just take our clothes and make little piles. So this is a t-shirt in the shirt category, and I'm gonna just put them on in front of me. These are leggings slash pants. I have some jeans, some more shirts, and then a jacket, which I'm gonna put right under the shirts. Oh, there's a t-shirt stuck to it. So you're just going to separate all your clothes to the best of your abilities. And it doesn't matter which order you do it, as long as you're just separating them and they don't have to be in a perfect pile. You're just, again, just separating them. Okay, and then I have some folded socks, but I'm going to refold them. More t-shirts, another t-shirt, and then my last leggings. And we're gonna be using this bin right here. This is gonna act as my drawer today. So once we fold all the clothes, we're going to organize them into this drawer, and you're gonna see how this folding technique helps to minimize the space, or to maximize the space, actually, not minimize, but to maximize your space. So you can fit a little bit more into these drawers. So here we go. All right, so we're gonna start with this t-shirt from the pile. And most t-shirts, if not, well, most have a logo in the front and sometimes a logo in the back. But if they don't, that's okay. You can differentiate between the front and the back because you can tell with the collar. But basically what you're going to do is take the front of your shirt and you're gonna kind of straighten it out this way, not too effective, but it helps get a little bit of the wrinkles out. At least I like to think so. And then you're gonna put the front side of your t-shirt down, or of your long sleeve, whichever. And you're gonna go ahead and straighten it out with your hands. One, to get out some of the wrinkles, to help us get a better fold. And with Marie Kondo, she likes to do this because what she says is, while you're straightening your shirt, you're resonating your energy levels, or your joy, she likes to say, into the shirt to essentially thank it for its service. So you can feel free to do that, but I'm just gonna go ahead and straighten it out. Okay, so now that it's fairly straightened, okay, it's not gonna be perfect, these are some pretty old shirts, but what you're going to do is take one side of your t-shirt. I'm gonna take the left side because it's the closest to me. But you're gonna take the left side of your shirt, or whichever side, and you're gonna go ahead and fold it. See how I'm folding it? Fold it about midway. So you can eyeball this, but you're gonna fold it about midway of the shirt. You're gonna go ahead and fold that, straighten it out. And then you're gonna take the sleeve and fold it just enough where it follows along this fold line right here as well, or just enough where it's touching the outer fold where we just folded in half. Okay, go ahead and straighten that. And then you're gonna take the other side and do the same thing where you fold it in the middle and kind of just fold the sleeves in this way. Okay, little tiny fixes that we have here, but that's okay. So now that you're in this step, and once you flatten out your clothes to the best of your ability, you're going to take your t-shirt and fold it in half. Okay, so you're going to take the bottom part of your shirt where you can kind of see the lining of it, and you're going to bring it just below the collar. So you're not covering it, but this is the collar, but just below it. Okay, go ahead and straighten that out. And it doesn't have to be a perfect match here. Okay, go ahead and straighten that out like I said. And then you're going to fold this into thirds. And how that's going to work is you're going to half it with your hand, like eyeball it. Bring the left side, this is the right side. Bring the right side of your shirt inward, so it's in the middle. Okay? And then you're going to flip it over again. So the key with this as well is if you can open up your shirt just a little bit. So once you fold it, it looks like this, right? And then you open up, you have to hold the collar and the lining, the bottom lining of the t-shirt together and the folds on the left side. If you can essentially stand it up like so, kind of looks like a triangle point or a tent. If you can point it up like so, then you know you've done it right. And this is going to be really important, which I'm going to explain later once we organize our clothes in the drawer. But this is going to be very helpful for later. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and put that on the side, all nice and folded. And we're going to work on our next t-shirt. So remember, the front side goes down. Move this out of our way a little bit. And I forgot to mention, but you will want a fairly spacious environment where you can fold your clothes. So you can be in your bedroom, could be in your living room, wherever, but as long as you have an open space, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and straighten or flatten my t-shirt, transfer that joyful energy Marie talks about, thanking my shirt for its service. And then I'm going to take the left side, eye the middle, straighten, fold the shirt, the sleeve back, just so that it's aligned just a little bit, so it doesn't fold like this, but it folds straight. Take the right side, do the same method. And it's okay if it overlaps a little bit. I know sometimes my clothes overlap because since I'm eyeballing it, there's no exact measurement. It's really doesn't matter too much unless you're picky, but I'm not too picky. So then we're going to fold it in half again, just below the collar, as you can see. And then we're gonna fold it into thirds. It's a little dusty here. Okay, so you're gonna fold it just like that in half, and then fold it into thirds one more time. Now you have two nice folds. And then we're gonna finish that with the rest of our pile. Straighten it out as best as you can. Go ahead and straighten it with your hands. Thank it. It sparks joy, things like that. And then you're gonna take the left side, or whichever side is facing you, and you're going to fold it as best as you can with the other part. So this side, which is my left side, I'm gonna fold it with the right side, okay? And I'm going to align it to the best of my abilities. I've had these pants for quite some time, so I think they've lost their shape, but that's okay. The lines don't always meet up. The original lines don't always meet up anymore, but that's okay. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and actually flip these, because if you didn't notice, most pants have this inner little, I like to call it a flap, inner little flap. And sometimes you can just fold it in, which I'm sure you'll see in some of my other pants folding techniques that I show you later or video. But if it is showing, then you can just go ahead and fold it inwards. But if it's not, you can just kind of arrange it so that it's part of the seam, the inside seam right there. So next, go ahead and just straighten these out. Okay, so next you're gonna take the bottom part of your pants and you're going to fold it in half. Okay, So it's going to be right under the bottom of the waistband, just like the t-shirt we wear under the collar. This is going to be under the waistband. And because these pants are slightly longer, instead of folding into thirds right away, I'm actually going to fold it in half again. Okay, so it's going to cover just a little bit of the waistband. There we go. You got to adapt however you can. Okay, so now that it's folded in half once more, I'm going to show you that again. So once you fold the bottom part in half, right under the waistband, you're going to fold it in half again from the bottom over the waistband just a little bit. So you have this, and then, okay, if the string falls out, that's fine. Then you're going to fold it in half again, because remember, our whole point is to get that little tent or triangle point, okay? So now you have a nice little pants, and you can put that on the side, and you're going to grab your other pants and work with it. And then we're going to move on to the jackets. I only have one jacket with me here today, but I'm going to show you how to fold it. And I'm not, like I said, I'm a beginner rusty. I'm not super great at folding jackets. I normally just put them on a hanger, like this jacket is on a hanger, because it's a little bit easier, because it is this one particularly, but jackets, the ones I have are typically heavier. So I put them on a hanger, but I'm going to show you how to fold it if you don't have access to a hanger or a closet. But I'm going to go ahead and put this on the side, okay? So we're going to be working with this other jacket here. The first thing you're going to want to do is zip up your jacket, find the zipper, and then zip that all the way up, okay? And then you're going to straighten that out, okay? You're going to go ahead and let the arms out. The sleeves. This would work the same way as if you were folding a long sleeve shirt. I know I didn't weigh, but so let's do a long sleeve. What you would do, or a t-shirt and whatnot, is you would flatten it out, right? Because we want it a little bit straight. And then you're going to eye the midline, okay? And then bring that fold over. Go ahead and let that sleeve kind of just fold over until you fix the bottom. Remember, it doesn't have to be perfect. Some jackets are kind of weird. That's okay. And then what you would do here is you would take the sleeve, and just like the t-shirt sleeve, we fold it back a little bit. But with long sleeves and jackets, we fold it so that it's touching the fold that we just did. But then, once you do that, you're going to kind of chop it where it meets that outer fold and bring it kind of diagonal downwards, okay? You can either do it that way or cut it diagonal and try to straighten it down, but you can get this little extra flap, and we don't want that. So go ahead and just do it diagonal as best as you can, okay? Then you're gonna go ahead and do the same thing to the other side. You're gonna bring, it's gonna just bring that flap over, which is fine. Okay, strain that out. Take your sleeve, okay? Fold it back, cut it, and bring it diagonally down. Okay, and then with the long sleeve, you would just fold this upwards and then do the three folds. But since this is jacket, you have a hood. So at this part, Marie brings the hood back and she flattens it. If I remember watching her video correctly, but she brings it backwards and then she'll fold this in half. So this jacket's a little weird, but she'll fold this in half. Okay, just under. And then she'll fold it in half again. So we won't do the three, but we'll fold it in half. So it's not perfect, but if you only have access to a drawer, then it works. This is how you fold your jacket with that technique. I'm gonna put that to the side now. Now we'll move on to the socks. So I have a few socks here that I normally wear, so they're cute character socks. But normally when your socks come out of the laundry, they are mixed up, unless you use one of those mesh bags that help keep it together. I typically don't, so they're pretty much everywhere. Not in this case, but in a normal case. But what you're gonna wanna do is, of course, just go ahead and pair them up first with their respective pair. Okay, so I'm gonna put some of these on the side and we'll work on these little sloth drinking coffee ones. This is a technique that I learned from my boyfriend actually to help keep the socks together. And I like this technique a little bit better than Murray's technique. So I thought I would just throw it in and show you all. But basically you're going to straighten or flatten out your sock. Okay, so there's a lining here where typically it'll tell you that this goes on top of your foot or your feet, and then the unlined goes on the bottom. So we're gonna try to match that up. Or you can follow where the heel part of the sock is. So I'll usually follow the heel part of the sock. But, so you're gonna go ahead and flatten that out. Then you're gonna put it on top of each other. So you're gonna take, since you have two, you're gonna take one sock and you're gonna put it right on top of each other. It doesn't matter left or right, just one on top of each other. You're gonna go ahead and flatten that out. You're going to take the bottom where it would be covering your toes, and you're going to fold it in half just under the little collar. He doesn't really do that, but Mory does. But this helps me. So then once you have folded that right under the ankle collar or ankle waist, whatever, I don't really know what this is called, but ankle lining, you're going to take the bottom part of your sock. Okay, so this is the technique that's going to be a little bit kind of hard, but not too hard. So you're gonna hold this together, but you're gonna take one of your thumbs and you're going to put it in the second sock so that you're holding everything together. You're gonna take your other hand, your free hand, and you're going to basically fold it inwards so that the outer part of your, or the inner part of your sock encapsulates your entire sock. So then you have it really nice and your pairs are together so you won't lose them. So when you're organizing them, you can still see, you know, the outline of it, the color, unless you have all the same colored socks, but you'll still be able to recognize it. Or you're like me, just choose whichever sock so you don't really look. So we're gonna go ahead and put that down. And then we're gonna bring in these socks and do the same thing, but I'm gonna show you the Mory way, which is pretty much the same thing. You're just not folding it, but straightening them out, putting one on top of the other, and you're pretty much just folding them into thirds, is how she does it. So this is what theoretically Mory would be doing. Like I said, I don't like this method because it's easy to just come undone, and I guess it's nice because you can see, you know, the characters, but if you're like me, I don't really care too much, or if you have all white socks, it doesn't matter. So we're just gonna go ahead and do the rest of the socks. So remember at the beginning of the video, we had this drawer. So now I'm gonna show you all how to organize your clothes. So we did our folds in sections. So we did shirts, pants, jackets, and socks. And I'm gonna put it in so y'all can see. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab the shirts, very carefully bring them all. And remember I told you all, it's supposed to be, all your clothes are supposed to be folded in a way that it can stand as kind of like a tent form. And the reason being, is when you organize your clothes and you put them in your drawer, you're able to put that little fold or tent looking fold in at the top. So for those of you who have a lot of shirts, t-shirts, you're able to see the different designs just a little bit and the different colors that you have, so you can better recognize your shirts. These clothes are organized. So there's sleeping clothes here. There are outer or outwear pants, jeans, and then jackets and some socks. So intimates can go here, like I've mentioned, but
this is how we would organize or could organize our clothes.
So this concludes the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed learning how to fold and organize your clothes with me. And I hope that you learned maybe a tip or two and will implement, since we do have a lot of time at home. I like to take this time to just rearrange pretty much everything in my closet and my drawers. So this would be a great way to reorganize that if you need something to do. But thank you all for watching this video. And again, I hope you all learned something, and I'll see you all in my next video, okay? Bye.